We're in our series called Beyond, and we started last Sunday. Everybody can join in this series on Sundays, and then also we've got this beautiful workbook, the Beyond Workbook, which you can get in the lobby. It's a guidebook for small groups. It's a six-week series that we're doing together, so you could gather a group of your friends and go through it together as a family or as a small group. And we encourage you to dive in with this into this material, because this is describing the power of God and the life that he came to bring us, everything that he offers to us in Jesus Christ. And so that's what we're going to talk about. And today I want to start off with a question for you about before and after. How many have seen dozens or hundreds of before and after ads in your lifetime? Like this one, for example, right? There's always a before story, and then, you know, if you take the pill or do the program or buy the product, right, then there's the after story. And this one, whatever this lady is doing, she's doing the right thing, all right? She's heading in the right direction. Here's one that's a little bit mind-blowing. This would be a good one for a dentist's office. All right, here's a before and an after, all right? I want this dentist's name for sure, because he did a good job. And then the before and after of the hoarding show. Oh my, look at that bathroom. What a transformation. My question for you is, what about your story? What's your before? Does anybody here remember what it was like before you met and found Jesus Christ? Do you remember how broken you were, how hopeless it was? And then what's the after? Where are you headed with God? Do you have everything? Have you arrived at the full after picture, or are you on your way? I'm on my way, all right? I'm not there. I haven't arrived, but there's a definite before in my life, and I can remember what it was like to be so lonely and so broken and so empty without Jesus Christ. And honestly, what God has done in my life and in Kathy's life as we came to the Lord as teenagers, it seeded every dream that we ever had. We didn't know when we turned our lives over to Jesus how far God was going to take us, how deeply he was going to bless us, how he was going to provide for us, how joyful and how happy we would be. And I don't believe I've entered into the fullness of what God has for me, and I don't believe you have either. I believe there's much, much more of a story to be told in your life about your after. And wherever you're at today, you might feel discouraged. You might feel like, well, you know, you're not quite there. You know, you're a little bit of a mess, or maybe you're a hot mess, as they say. But if you have Christ in your life, he's taking you somewhere. He's taking you to an after. And I would say he's taking you beyond where you are now into the best part of your life. My message today is very simple. Jesus Christ came to bring us into a beyond life, beyond where we're at today. There is more for you, and we're going to talk about that life wherever you're at. Maybe you're in a crummy place, or maybe you're in the best place you've ever been, but I just want to challenge you that God has more for you. He wants this after picture that he's creating of your life is beyond what you have imagined. John 10, verse 10 is the scripture that we're going to begin with. The J.B. Phillips translation says, and this is Jesus speaking, and he says, "The thief comes with the sole intention of stealing, killing, and destroying." That's what the enemy does. "But I came," Jesus said, "to bring them life and far more than before." There was a before for you. There was a before for me. But Jesus came to take us way past what we had before and into what I would call the beyond life. And today, my message is for you. And that is that God has more for you. There's a beyond, there's an after, and there's a lifestyle that God wants to bring us into. You see, everything that Jesus came to do is about beyond. It's about the after. It's about where you're headed. Everything that he came to do. If you just stop and think about the cross, when he died on the cross, what was that all about? Well, that was him paying the price so that we could have a beyond life. If you think about the church, If you think about the church is the community of the beyond life. It's the people of the beyond life. If you think about the resurrection, which came right after his death, that was the proof of the beyond life. If you think about the gospel, what is the gospel message that Jesus came preaching? That's the message of the beyond life. If you think about your heart and what God wants to do in your heart is the container. Your heart is the thing that can carry this life. It's the receptacle of the new life that Jesus came to bring. If you think about the Holy Spirit, what does the Holy Spirit do? He provides the power for the beyond life. If you think about the Great Commission and our command to go into all the world and preach the gospel, that's the call to spread the beyond life. Everything. What I'm trying to say is that everything that Jesus came to do, the gospel, the Holy Spirit, the Bible is our guidebook in the beyond life. Everything that Jesus came is about this life that brings you into something that is beyond where you were. Now, let me ask you a question. How many of you are ready to go a little bit further in life with Jesus Christ? The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus came to bring you into something that's greater after than it is before. With all this in mind, there's a question I want to put on the table. Understanding the cross and the resurrection and the church and the Bible and everything that Jesus came and the promise that he made, let me ask you this question. He said, I came that you might have life. My question is, are you living in the fullness of that? Are you where you want to be in life, or is there more for you? Because today I want to talk about three things that will take us into the beyond life, the life that Jesus came to give us. I want to look at 1 John chapter 3, verse 1, 1 John 3, 1, where the Bible says, consider the kind of extravagant love that the Father has lavished on us. Think about a lavish life that God wants to bring to every one of us. He calls us the children of God. That word lavish speaks about abundance. It speaks about having more than enough. It speaks about an overflow. It's the after picture of where God is taking you. And he wants to bless you in ways you have never dreamed of, beyond your wildest dreams. It's a life where you're living to a degree that you never thought would be possible, living supernaturally, experiencing God's power. And God will bless you with good things like houses and cars, and he's good that way. But the life that God has for us is so much more than just natural material possessions. That life that God wants to bring us in is about a joy and a peace that we can have on the inside. Let me ask you today, what are you carrying? People in our culture today carry anxiety, they carry stress, they carry fear. It's with them everywhere they go. But if you can carry anxiety and you can carry fear with you everywhere you go, that means you were born with the capacity to hold on to things. You're holding on to stress, you're holding on to fear, and you're carrying it with you everywhere you go. You carry it into your bedroom, you carry it to work. But let me ask you this. What would happen if you became a carrier of the new life of Jesus Christ? So that instead of bearing with you all the time, everywhere you go, you have anxiety and stress and fear. Instead, you were carrying joy and you were carrying love and you were carrying peace. If you would dream that that is possible, I want to say to you that if you will turn your life over to Christ, you can carry that with you everywhere you go. There's a life that is beyond where you are living right now. And Jesus paid the full price on the cross so that you could carry that with you. It's a lavish life. It's an aftershot of you. It's something that's beyond anything that you ever dreamed was possible. And I'd like to talk to us about it in this message. Now, if you're watching this in your small group by video, you can take your Beyond Workbook to lesson number 2 and start working through the material. Enjoy a great time together discussing the Word of God.